Good morning, dear students. Once again, I am here with another story from Footprints Without Feet, that is The Necklace, which is written by Guy de Maupassant. About the writer, Guy de Maupassant is regarded as the best French writer of short stories. His 300 stories were written in the naturalist style and often described the life of the lower and middle classes. Bol de Souf, any ball of fat, is regarded as his best story, while the best known is La Parure, that is The Necklace. He took his last breath on July 6, 1893. His nationality is France and his date of birth is August 5, 1850. The story Necklace is a story with a strong message. So let's start with the story. The short story The Necklace by Guy de Maupassant takes place in France several hundred years ago. Matilda Loisel lives in a flat with her husband, who works as a clerk for Minister of Education. Their lives are not luxurious. That means they are not very rich people, but they are not poor. That means they lived a life of a middle class family, mere simple. Matilda, however, longs to be rich. Longs to be rich means she wanted to be rich. She envies her friend Ma'am Forrester, who has a large house and lots of jewelry. So Ma'am Forrester is Matilda's childhood friend and she envies her a lot. One day, her husband brings home an invitation to a ball. He thinks his wife will be excited to attend such a fancy party, but instead she is upset. She complains that she has nothing suitable to wear to such an extravagant occasion. Her kind husband agrees to give her the 400 francs that he had been saving to buy a new rifle to get herself a gown. The week of the party, Matilda seems anxious again. That means again she was not happy. When her husband asks her why, she frets that she has no jewelry to wear with her dress. So at first, her husband gave her the money which he has saved for himself to buy a gun. But he gave that money to Matilda to buy a gown. Now when she had a gown, the problem was that she was not having the matching jewelry to wear for the grand party. So her husband suggested her that perhaps she could borrow something from her friend Ma'am Forrester. Matilda goes to Ma'am Forrester's house and picks out a sparkling diamond necklace to borrow. So I told you earlier, Ma'am Forrester is Matilda's schoolmate and she was generous enough when she went her to ask for a jewelry. Ma'am Forrester was generous enough that she gave all the boxes of jewelry to her, kept in front of her and asked her to choose the necklace she wants to wear. The night of the ball arrived and Matilda was happy at the occasion. She looked very beautiful in the dress. Everyone liked her and she was absolutely thrilled. She was the talk of the party. Everybody was admiring her beauty, admiring her necklace. She and her husband enjoyed a lot at the gala and did not leave until 4 a.m. That means up till 4 a.m. they were at the party enjoying themselves. Then they caught a cab and returned home. After returning home, before changing her dress, Matilda wanted to have final view of herself in her glory. That means she wanted to admire herself once again. As she looked herself in a mirror, she uttered a cry. And why she uttered a cry? Because her necklace was not around her neck. The precious necklace of her friend has been lost. Her husband goes out to search the streets but returns empty-handed. That means the necklace was lost. To stall for time, that means to hold for time, Matilda writes to her friend that she broke the clasp and is having it repaired. So She sent a note to her, giving an excuse why she was not able to return the necklace. So she wrote to her that she has broken the clasp of the necklace and she is getting it repaired, so it will take some time. In the meantime, they find another necklace that matches the missing one, but it cost 36,000 francs, which is a huge amount for Loisel's. Her husband fortunately inherited 18,000 francs from his father. Luckily, Mr. Loisel was having 18,000 francs, which he has inherited from his father. But another 18,000 francs, they have to arrange or they have to borrow it from someone. But they will need to borrow the rest of the money. Finally, they have enough to purchase the replacement necklace, and Matilda gives it to Ma'am Forrester, who doesn't even look at it. The next 10 years, Matilda's life changes dramatically. So, to borrow the money and to return the money was not an easy task for the Loisels. They had to lead a very miserable life, and what kind of life they led for these 10 years is here. The next 10 years, Matilda's life changes dramatically. They move to a smaller apartment where she has to cook and clean for herself. That means they shifted to a rented apartment. She also does work on the side while her husband works multiple jobs to pay back all the money they borrowed. After 10 years, the money is all paid back, but Matilda has aged a great deal. That means she lost her beauty. One day she sees Ma'am Forrester on the street. She decides to tell her the truth about the necklace. So she went to her friend to tell her whole thing about the necklace, how she lost the necklace and what all she has gone through to return her necklace. Ma'am Forrester is stunned by Matilda's appearance. At first she was not able to recognize Matilda because she has grown so old. Matilda explains that it is indirectly because of Ma'am Forrester, since she lost the necklace she borrowed from her and had to pay for a replacement. Shocked, Ma'am Forrester confesses that the necklace Matilda borrowed was a fake. That means she told her that it was not of real diamond, it was just made of paste and it cost only 500 francs, and they bought the necklace which cost 36,000 francs. So she bought the necklace made of pure diamond, but her necklace was not of pure diamond. See here, if Matilda would have told her friend about the lost necklace, she would not have gone through so much of hardship. Instead of hiding the things from her, she should have straight away went and talked to her friend. So if she would have talked, she would have never gone through such a hard life. So the moral of this story, the message we learn from the story, that first, the appearance can be deceptive. How? The necklace which looked like a diamond necklace was not originally a diamond necklace, it was a duplicate one, right? Secondly, it also teaches us that we should not pine after material possessions. We should not run after material possessions, but realize we are lucky with what we have. So in simple words, if I say, it means that we should be content with what we have. We should not be greedy. We should not run after material possessions, but we should be happy that whatever God has given us is more than enough, and we should be thankful to Him for whatever He has given to us. With this, we come to the end of the story. It's a very interesting story and a very with a good message. Try to find out the question answers of this, though I have already given you. Please go through the chapter, read it once. It's my sincere request to all of you.